2016 is the second power. I told you before, man, that goddamn Trayvon Martin case was white people, was the marking point for white people to announce to the goddamn world that the goddamn Hispanic is the new nigga. Alright? And that we are gonna now do an operation on eliminating niggas from the face of the planet. Okay? It's too many goddamn people, and niggas have shown themselves to be the weakest of all the groups. Okay? The weakest of all the groups. You haven't done shit to establish yourself as respectable and as a strong, as a strength amongst in the affairs of men. Okay? You haven't done shit. Alright? To establish yourself as a nation. Alright? And as a strength in the affairs of men. Alright? So, they saying this. Some motherfuckers gotta go. Who's the motherfucking bottom motherfuckers on the totem pole? And it's the niggas. When you supposed to been, if them motherfuckers was in first place, you should have been second. And because you've been playing, partying, and bullshitting, and because you got complacent, you got comfortable, and you become all right with being a goddamn second-class citizen, and you've gone from a second-class citizen now to what's considered a permanent fucking underclass. Permanent underclass. Meaning, ain't nothing else below a nigga. Nothing is below a nigga. Okay? Even the goddamn bushmen in the jungles who walk around and goddamn half-naked with loincloths, even they feed themselves. They don't depend on another group to sell them food. They grow their own food and they hunt their own food. So they have more goddamn freedom and sovereignty than goddamn black people in America. Because your total existence, our total existence, depend on the goddamn generosity of crackers. We ain't growing our own food. We ain't doing shit for ourselves, man. Not a goddamn thing. So at least the goddamn motherfuckers in the Brazilian rainforest or some goddamn uncharted island, some unknown tribal motherfuckers, even got more goddamn strength and freedom than you. And if somebody do come to their land, they kill them motherfuckers off the muscle. They call them headhunters and all kinds of shit. They don't play no goddamn games. They ain't scared to fight. You understand? And they got more respect from crackers because when they kill some first group crackers, usually the cracker, the word goes out, them motherfucking headhunters, stay fuck off that island. You know what I mean? And they don't go back. You understand? They don't go back. See, that's what happens when you fight. When you fight them motherfuckers, see? When you fight them motherfuckers, you get respect. And that's why I always told you, you don't have to always win. You just got to put up a good goddamn fight. You understand? You just have to show these motherfuckers, man, that, hey, man, you can't fuck with us, man. You can't fuck with us, motherfucker. You know? You can't fuck with us, motherfucker. You fuck with us, you gonna die. You understand that shit? You niggas done got in your minds and shit that if you was to go up against a white man, you gonna be the only motherfuckers dying. Like, they you know, you got this goddamn subconscious belief that these motherfuckers are gods, man. And you know you do. Oh, so don't fucking say you don't. Because you've made these motherfuckers in your mind larger than life. You've made these motherfuckers immortal. You understand? You've made these motherfuckers immortal, man. Like, if you was to go to war with these goddamn white people, you're going to be the only ones dying, and they not.
And now presenting Pharaoh Allah on YouTube. They call him Young Pharaoh.
You inherit genes or receive genes from somebody else other than in a sexual manner. So basically through basically somebody else giving you their genes or injecting you with their genes other than in a sexual manner. So now with that being said, now the Anunnaki blood type, once again, is O. Most black people have an O blood type. Now, in my first video, in my video, 76 trillion year history of the black race, part one, I state that we were created by our black ancestors from the 19th galaxy, known as the Anunnaki, as, let's just say, a force to do labor in order to help them get gold to restore their atmosphere, and in return, they would give us the knowledge and science of the universe, which we would use to build great civilizations such as Kemet and all these other great things that white people just can't never figure out how we built. So now with that being said, now, 97, according to Science Today, 97% out of 100% Humans only use 3% of our DNA's codons are unlocked. 97% are locked, which means somebody locked them. So when we were genetically created, when our bodies were genetically created from the Anunnaki, the African people I'm talking to, black people, why this shows and proves that they did not want us to access our full power as on a level as theirs for a certain amount of time, because right now, like I just said, 97% of the DNA is locked. We only use 3%. So who locked the, who, somebody had to have locked these DNAs or were able to control this DNA in order to lock it, because surely this DNA did not lock itself. So now with 97% of the DNA being locked and only 3% being accessible, you have to use your intelligence to say, damn, well, who locked this DNA and why would they want to lock it? This coincides with the story that our ancestors tell, that a being or entity from the 19th galaxy known as the Anunnaki, the Elohim, and the Bible, they're known as the fallen angels. This corresponds with that. They created us to help for us to mine gold, and then they would teach us. Because if they created us 100% like them, then there would be no need for us to teach us, because we would have the full capabilities of them. So now with this being said, even though we do possess psychic and kinetic abilities and do have great abilities, is not to the extent of the Anunnaki, because all of our DNA is locked. But now it was only supposed to be locked for a certain amount of time. So now what's happening is, right now that we just came into the Aquarian age, actually the DNA codons of black people is unraveling, and the DNA sequences are actually unlocking. So now, right now, we probably use way more than 3% of our DNA. And this is why black people are waking up, and our melanin, our carbon 12, is actually remanifesting itself back into another form. So now what we're finna do is we're finna transcend the physical realm, and we're finna go from the 3D to the 5th dimension, and all this locked DNA that black people have are actually unlocking right now. And this is why white people go so hard to try to kill us. This is why they poison the water, like they put fluoride in the water, because fluoride calcifies your pineal gland, and the pineal gland is what helps you use your kinetic abilities. So you think white people just don't know the science about us or know who we are? Are they trying to calcify our pineal glands on accident? This is a deliberate attack. This is a deliberate attack, and this is just one of the many attacks. But moving on, before I get off subject, so now I have just connected the blood type with the Anunnaki and showed you why the DNA was locked for a certain period. Now, it was locked due to other reasons, and black people, we were going through a universal karma, and we weren't allowed to be fully at our power for a certain reason, because we had to go through a certain amount of spiritual evolution to become humble enough and responsible enough to harness our powers once given back to us. But outside of that, now, further proving my point. Now, I just talked about 97% of the DNA is locked and only 3% we use, right? Well, in this, because we know that DNA, the DNA is held within the gene. Well, the body is made up of 20,000 to 25,000 genes. Well, my number from personal research, I got 224 genes. But just according to Google, you can Google it. According to Google, 145 of those genes are exactly, quote, Google says, alien genes, foreign to this planet. So what the hell is we doing with foreign genes inside of our DNA that didn't come from this planet? And then whose genes is Google talking about? Because we know that chem means black, and the street means the study of black. Chemistry means the study of black, black melanin, dark matter. So we know that white people make a living studying us on a daily basis, and this is how they are able to even create medicines or drugs to target black people, because they study us on a daily, which means they have been studying our DNA and have found that we have, according to them, 145 foreign alien genes in our DNA. They categorize you and then put your statistics on them. And if you don't believe me, you can look this up. White people populate so little bit of the planet that in the year 2000, they actually label anybody of Hispanic descent, classify them as white to make their statistics go up. So white people, I forgot the exact number, but let's just make a number up right now, just hypothetically speaking. Let's say white people was like 13% of the planet, people in the U.S. in 2000. They didn't want everybody to know that. So what they did was, if you came to jail or you came to the U.S. anywhere and you wrote that you was Hispanic on a paper, then they would classify you automatically as white. So now white people, little population went from 13% to like 78% of the people in America. so that they can fool you and think that you're the minority and they're not, but they're really the minority. If you don't believe me and you're a Spanish person right now, if you ever been to jail, I bet you your shit say white. I bet you some of y'all shit classified as white. You're not white. But I know you probably looked at that jail ID too and said, damn, why this shit say I'm white? Because of that census that they did in 2000. I can't think of the name right now. I'm mad it's in the back of my brain, but go look it up. But with that being said, black people, we are divine descendants, and the only way to unlock your DNA right now is the time. The sun is going to give off a solar. The sun is giving off a solar flare right now. It's going to heat up the is heating up the planet right now. And we all know that heat does what? It loosens up molecules. Just like when you put ice in heat, it melts because the molecules are getting loose. So to give you an example, this is a solid. So you got gas, liquid, solid. So my hand represents molecules. A solid is when the molecules are tightly compressed. A liquid is when they have a little bit of room to vibrate. They always vibrate no matter what, but they have more room to move around as they vibrate. A gas is when they have the most room to move around. So right now, when the sun, as the sun is heating up, it's loosening up the molecules in the body. Particularly, we're talking about the DNA. The DNA is going to be unlocked by the sun, because remember, the sun is conscious and it has intelligence. So the sun knows that while we are in the Aquarian age, to send us the energies in order to lock the DNA codons for us to access more percent of the DNA that has been unlocked. And then the melanin is the number one conductor of this energy, which is going to aid in this process. So now boom, black people, this is the time right now, and you're going to actually be stuck in this realm, black people. I'm warning you now. We are jumping from the third dimension to the fifth dimension. You will be stuck in this dimension if you do not clean up your mind, if you do not clean up your diet, because your diet holds you at a low vibration frequency. If you don't believe me, go on YouTube and type in Pharaoh Spirit Diet and watch my video on a spirit, on a diet, and it's going to teach you everything I'm trying to say. If you don't clean up your diet, if you don't clean up your mind, and you don't clean up your mental, your spiritual, your physical being in totality, instead of just focusing on one in totality, you will be stuck on this paradigm. And white people know this. This is why in a crooked ass Bible that they put the hidden stories in, they put in there, the devil does what? He knows when God comes back, he's going to hell. So he wants everybody to go to hell with him. Hell is just the lowest frequency of vibration. And God is the highest extended in mind. But we can use God as the allegory, as the sun, because Helios, Biblios. Helios means sun, book, and Biblios means book or papers. White people understood that the sun gives energy. So the sun, Ra, the Egyptian sun god, the son of God, when the sun comes back, when God comes back and it gives off the solar flare, it's going to take us into the higher frequency, the higher God plane. And white people, due to them lacking melanin and no longer being of the royal blood heritage because they are defective mutations of black people, know that they can't get on this plane. So what they do is they poison you in the fluoride to calcify your pineal gland. They poison you with fluoride in your water and everything else, toothpaste, everything. And they influence you to have a messed up diet and a million other things I could name in order to keep you at this low frequency. So right now, as we're shifting into another dimension or paradigm, you are stuck vibrating here with them. So black people, if you really don't want to go to hell, clean up your damn actions, clean up your mind, and clean up your mentality. And with that being said, because I don't want to make this video too long, we are divine descendants, and black people, know who you are and love yourself. This planet is ours. And I'm not saying that we shouldn't aid and be of service to those whom we share it with, but if somebody is being negative to you or your planet, they must be eradicated from your life. So I'm not saying be violent. I'm saying be intelligent. And you let this guide you. And with that being said, family, I know who I am. Do you? Peace. The spine must be straightly aligned, because if not, then the energy cannot flow up the spine. It'd be like the equivalent of taking a garden hose and bending it, and the water getting stuck at one point. That would be the equivalent to the chakras becoming stuck at one point at in a vertebrae of the spine.
The future Buddha in this same temple being attacked, not for doing anything wrong, except for speaking the truth of the history of the black people of America. They have the fate of those who attack, because the black people of America has been programmed and bred to attack their own kind first. Don't do it no more. This temple speaks loud and clear. You don't want to do that to the one who brings you the truth. You want to sit back and talk, and talk, and talk. Your ancestors refer to this. This is turning the wheel of the law. And the name of the one who comes back to turn the wheel of the law is called Nigga Junior, or Nigga Juna. He explains the secret teachings of the Africans of Asia. The wheel of the law is the teaching that there is no death, that life is eternal, and his job is to prove that. When he appears, he'll be living on a hill. He'll be across from an island like Manhattan.
What did you say?
When he appears, he'll be living on a hill. He'll be across from an island like Manhattan, living in a tower. You see, he's also known as Nigga Junie. He is the one commissioned to do that work for the African. He says he received the treatise on which he expounded and developed the Mahayana school from the serpent gods, the niggas, and that the nigger king himself revealed to Nigga Juna the holy text in the Dragon Palace under the sea. That's like America. They further claim that Gautama Buddha, the Buddha, had given this treatise called the Prajnaparamita to the niggas to guard until such a time, it's a specific time now, as the world should become sufficiently enlightened to understand its transcendent wisdom. And that the niggas, after converting this individual, Nigga Juni, to Buddhism, handed over to him their precious treasure. Now let's take a look at what the precious treasure is. It's on the bottom line. They said they handed over to him their precious treasure. The precious treasure is the evidence and the proof of life after death. That's the bottom line. They refer to this as their precious treasure because it's the only thing that God wants to hear at this point in time. It's the only thing in the world that they preach. Praying, stomping, testify means nothing. It's the teaching of life after death, and this is God's gift to the Negro. God has decided to give this to the Negro to make the Negro his appointed people.
Yes, wasn't that fascinating? You all must sub both of those brothers on their channels. Anyway, now you see about the pine nuts, the pine cone, the DNA. Pharaoh Allah was right. You all have to check out his channel as well. Happy New Year, everybody. Good night and Amen, the four letters.
Say that the name Amen went through religion, went through Christianity, Islam, Judaism, and people are sealing off their prayers with the name Amen, which is the sacred name of God that they're not sharing with you in religion.